Now, the final observation is that we actually know how to come up with an approximation for the eigenvalue that is smallest in magnitude, or rather, as we converge to it, we can get better and better approximations for it. How is that? Well, we saw that if x is an eigenvector of A, then if all the values we run into are real valued, x transpose Ax divided by x transpose x is actually equal to the associated eigenvalue. Now, if we have an approximation for the vector x, then this yields an approximation for the eigenvalue. This is known as the Rayleigh quotient. Now, what does that mean? Well, that means that if we're iterating here, and let's say we're iterating in such a way that at every step we keep our vector of length 1, then at the end of the iteration we could compute a shift that now is dependent on our iteration, and that shift could be set to vk plus 1 transpose a vk plus 1. Now, why don't we have to divide here? Well, because we already normalized our v to be of size 1, of length 1. Now, obviously, we can do this at the bottom, or we can do this at the top of the iteration. The important thing here is that we then shift by that shift in the next iteration. By then, k has been updated to the next value, so we need to use rho sub k here. And now we have something where the closer we get to our solution, the better this ratio becomes, because in the limit, this right here becomes 0, and this right here becomes lambda m minus 2 minus lambda m minus 1, the distance between the smallest two eigenvalues. And this gives astonishingly fast convergence. And it's known as the Rayleigh quotient iteration.